Hi, I'm Bill Bellamy from MTV. You may not think I have anything in common with Oprah Winfrey or Diane Sawyer, but I do. I got to spend some time with Michael Jackson, and I found out some things about him that they did. Thank you. MTV held a press conference to announce the nominations for the 1995 Video Music Awards. Michael was there to witness Scream, the duet he performs with his sister Janet, receive a record-breaking 11 nominations. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Michael Jackson. Janet, and the video has been nominated for 11 MTV Video Music Awards, and that hasn't happened in the last decade. How does that make you feel?
Very, very honored, and I'm sure Janet is too. I mean, we worked very hard on it, and it just to reap the fruits of you know, this type of thing, it's a wonderful achievement.
It's awesome.
I'm very happy.
Yeah, the first time we've ever worked together, sang together, aside from PYT, but that's just a little background thing he asked me to do, so I said yes and did it. That was years ago. It was fun. It was really fun working with him in the studio, and we wrote the song. It was very interesting to see him work at work, because I hadn't seen him in a really long time. I think the last time I saw him at work was the Thriller album, really. Just being there in the studio with him and just watching. Most definitely, I did feel that little sister thing. It'll always be that way, because that's what I am. And he's my big brother.
When I watch the video, it's so much energy in the video. You guys are just like electric. What was it like working together, like doing it, the dancing and the whole thing?
It was great, because we love to dance. And to get in a room and dance with my sister reminds me of old times.
Okay.
Because it allowed us to play and goof off and throw stuff, and it was fun. The making of is as much fun as seeing the real short.
You know, you gotta do another video for us, because we're loving it.
Yeah. Thank you.
When we look at your videos, they're very innovative. They're always on the cutting edge. I mean, how much are you involved with the creative process of the videos?
Very much, because I pretty much come up with the concepts, and I like to collaborate. On this one, I didn't do the concept. It was done by the director.
Okay.
But I pretty much like to conceptualize and choreograph. But it's always a collaborative effort on everything.
Of all your videos, when you think back, what is Michael Jackson's favorite video?
My favorite? Mm-hmm. Probably something like Thriller or Smooth Criminal, like kind of rough edge.
Yeah.
We can do more of that kind of stuff.
You gonna do some more stuff like that?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah! I'm Bill Bellamy. When History was released, Michael was criticized for some of the lyrics in They Don't Care About Us. He was so upset at the thought of his lyrics being misconstrued and possibly hurting his friends and fans that he decided to change the words.
All I wanna say is that they don't really care about us. Beat me, hate me, you can never break me. Will me, thrill me, you can never kill me. Shoot me, sue me, everybody do me. Kick me, cut me, don't you black.
The new recording of the album is in the stores right now, and Michael, you're an artist known for producing your own material, but you also collaborated with a lot of others. How do you choose who you want to work with?
Gee, I pretty much don't pretty much pick the artist I want to work with. It kind of just happens spontaneously. I think they present something that I think is interesting, and we kind of collaborate on it.
Who would you love to work with that you haven't worked with yet?
It would probably be somebody like Tchaikovsky or Claude Debussy, an artist that, you know, is not around anymore.
Who are some of the people that you collaborated with on History?
I work with R. Kelly. I worked with Notorious B.I.G. I worked with Boyz II Men, who were phenomenal.
It was exciting. I mean, you know, being in the studio with Michael Jackson. For one, Michael wasn't even supposed to be in the studio. He had a session at another studio, and he actually moved his session over to our studio just so he could be involved in the session. And, you know, we felt good about that, because a lot of artists, you know, or a lot of people who work with, you know, artists like Michael Jackson, Madonna, things like that, people tend to ask them, you know, so how was it working with so-and-so and so-and-so? And they say, well, you know, they weren't there, you know, we just went in and did so forth and so on. But, you know, Michael was actually there when we were recording, so we felt like, you know, we were major contributors to the album since he took his time to come over and be a part of the session. So
you don't think you're going to ever get a chance to talk to him because, you know, you people think that he's so untouchable, and that's the way we felt until we actually talked to him and met him. Right.
He could have told us things that we already knew, and we would have, like, found some like new type of way to look
for
at
real,
it.
Michael, blow your nose with a
Michael's
tissue.
Like the
blow your nose with a tissue. Wow.
Okay. My friend Shaq told me that.
Yeah, Shaquille O'Neal, right?
Yeah,
of course.
Shaq,
he was,
you know,
great.
Big daddy.
My friend of Michael's came to my house one day.
And he was really nervous, you know. He said he didn't believe it. He was like, he wanted to scream. He said,
I couldn't scream because, you know, I didn't want to be like a little, you know, so.
But, you know.
He was great.
He loved you also.
Yeah.
So was that a lot of fun working with
these
guys? Yeah.
He asked me to, you know, do a verse on his album. So I said, yeah. I know. Can't say no. So I had to represent.
For the new video, there's a song that's written and produced by R. Kelly.
Right.
How did you guys hook up together with this?
It was a song that he presented, and I liked it.
And Barry Hankerson, my manager, came to me and asked me, did I want to work with Michael? You know, he didn't want to say the last name. It kind of threw me off. I thought he was talking about Jordan. But it came out to be he was talking about Michael Jackson. I thought about it for less than a second. And I said, yeah, man, I love to work with him. You know, so it actually happened. And we went in the studio. He heard the song I did. Actually, I did the song just like him, you know, as far as imitating his voice and everything. He liked it. So he came to Chicago and we nailed the song.
Actually, we produced this one together.
Okay.
And, I mean, it just was a wonderful song. So it was really done. He's a wonderful artist.
It's a truly beautiful song. I mean, the first time I heard it, I like immediately. I mean, was that the type of impact when you heard it too?
Yeah. For me, I always have to hear it twice.
Two times?
Yeah.
Two times?
Even if I love it, I want to hear it again. Uh-huh. But I loved it.
Everything I do, I like to say that I've experienced the song. So I have went through some drama, you know, and I lost a few people in my life, and it inspired me to come up with a song like that.
Now let's take a look at the world premiere of Michael Jackson's You Are Not Alone.
Another day has gone.
And all over the world, who make such a big deal about race.